One of the major goals of paleontology is to bring ancient creatures to life. How do they move? What do they eat? And where do they live? We can answer questions like this using the hard, bony parts of fossils and the rocks in which they're preserved. But what did ancient creatures actually look like? What colours were they? Until recently, we thought it was impossible to answer these questions because we thought that evidence of colour couldn't survive in fossils. And so reconstructions of what ancient creatures looked like were thought to be little more than artists' fancy with very little scientific evidence. But thanks to some new and really exciting fossil discoveries, we now know that these old ideas are wrong. Many fossils do preserve evidence of colour, and this is really important because colour tells us about how animals communicate with each other. Sometimes hints of fossil colour are obvious. For instance, many fossil insects preserve brilliant metallic colours, bright blues, greens, yellows, and reds. These fossil metallic colours are strikingly similar to the metallic colours that we see in many modern insects. And what's really interesting is that these fossil colours aren't produced by pigments, by chemicals. Instead, they're produced by amazingly tiny nanostructures deep inside the insect's outer shell. When we study these beautiful, colourful metallic fossil insects with powerful electron microscopes, we can see some very tiny structures, very precisely arranged layers in the insect's outer shell. And these layers are incredibly thin. They're only about 100 nanometers thick, and that's about a tenth the width of a human hair. And what's incredible is that these layers are so thin that they actually interact with light. The thicker layers scatter longer wavelengths of light, so produce red colours, whereas the thinner layers scatter shorter wavelengths of light and produce blue colours. One way to test this is to do fossilisation experiments. If you take tiny pieces of cuticle from modern insects, pop it into these little gold cells, and then heat them up to really high pressures and temperatures, we can actually simulate the conditions that happen deep inside the Earth's crust when fossils get buried. When we do this, we find that the original colour does not preserve. Our originally green beetle here, during the experiments, turned turquoise, blue, purple, and eventually black. This change happens because during the experiments, the layers producing the colour become thinner, blue shifting the colours. And what's more, the chemistry of the cuticle changes too. So basically, our experiments are telling us that the colours of the fossil insects are not the same colours that they had when they were alive millions of years ago. But that's not all. Not only do fossils preserve evidence of structural colours, but we can also find evidence of fossil pigments, in other words, chemicals that produce colour. And when we look around us today, many of the colours we see in the natural world are produced by pigments, things like the brown colours of our freckles, the red colours of tomatoes, and the green colours of plants. Many of these pigments decay away very soon after an animal dies, and so traces of pigments are rarely found in fossils. But sometimes, under special conditions, traces of pigments do preserve. For instance, some fossil feathers preserve evidence of the pigment melanin. That's the same pigment that produces the browns and reds of some feathers in modern birds, and also colours our freckles and our hair. The evidence for fossil melanin comes in the form of these microscopic objects shaped like tiny sausages and tiny footballs. And because in modern birds, the footballs are linked to reddish colours and the sausages are linked to dark brown and black colours, we can infer the colour of fossil feathers. But what about skin colours? Well, that's trickier because the skin of most vertebrates contains a whole bunch of different pigment cells that usually don't fossilise. But again, under special conditions, even the pigment cells in the skin can preserve. This fossil snake died 10 million years ago on the edges of a deep lake in northeast Spain. And it's extremely special because it contains the best examples of preserved skin in the entire fossil record. when we look at the microscopic structure of the skin, we can see these beautiful sinuous collagen fibers winding their way around these blobby features. These are the preserved pigment cells. We can see melanophores, which produce black and brown colours, xanthophores, which make reds and yellows, and iridophores, which combine with the xanthophores to make beautiful bright green colours. We're now trying to fill in the gaps and try to find evidence of other pigments and colour-producing structures in diverse fossils from around the world and from different ages. And in the end, we want to answer questions like, when did colour evolve? And why? Why did animals start using colour? Going forwards, these fossils are like pieces of a giant jigsaw puzzle that will allow us to piece together the evolution of colour in animals through deep time over millions of years.